नमस्ते, मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर अंजना देशमुख, फिजिशियन एट हेडगेवार हॉस्पिटल इन असोसिएशन विथ ISTD औरंगाबाद चैप्टर. आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट अ टॉपिक प्रिवेंशन एंड कंट्रोल ऑफ कम्युनिकेबल डिसीजेस. नाउ इन दिस टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू कवर व्हाट आर कम्युनिकेबल डिसीजेस, टाइप्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेबल डिसीजेस, टाइप्स ऑफ डिसीज ट्रांसमिशन और चेन ऑफ इन्फेक्शन एंड प्रिवेंशन ऑफ कम्युनिकेबल डिसीजेस. Now, what are communicable diseases? A disease that is spread from one living thing to another or through the environment. What is pathogen? An organism that causes the disease. And what is infection? A condition that occurs when pathogens enter the body, multiply and damage body cells. It could be a mild to severe or life-threatening. As we see, a very simple mild disease which can be a common cold, and it can be a life-threatening like COVID. It can be a recovering within a small duration, or sometimes it could be lifelong. So recovering of its own will be a common cold, and if it remains lifelong is a HIV infection. Now we are going to see common communicable diseases. So a viral common communicable diseases such as AIDS, chickenpox, cold, hepatitis, smallpox, polio, rabies, influenza, measles, herpes, and viral pneumonia, COVID-19, and chikungunya. Now, common bacterial diseases which are communicable are bacterial pneumonia, diphtheria, foodborne diseases, gonorrhea, Lyme's disease, tuberculosis, and strep throat. Now, common fungal infections which are communicable are athlete's foot and ringworm and mucormycosis. Now, protozoal infections are amoebic dysentery and malaria. Now, types of disease transmission. An organism such as tick which carries and transmits pathogens to human and animals such as dengue and malaria. The water and food. Because of careless handling and storage of food, these are the sources of contamination of food leading to a disease such as typhoid. And airborne diseases where a pathogen is excreted or pathogen will come out from a human being through sneeze or coughing and may float in the air and will spread the infections such as chickenpox and tuberculosis. Now we will see a video which is self-explanatory.
Communicable diseases. Our health is affected by many infectious diseases that spread from one person to another. These are caused by bacteria, viruses, and other microorganisms called pathogens. Some of these diseases are explained here. Airborne disease. Many infectious diseases spread by pathogens carried by air. When an infected person coughs or sneezes, tiny droplets of moisture that may contain the pathogens are expelled into the air. People breathing in these droplets are likely to get infected. Waterborne diseases. Consumption of infected water causes diseases like typhoid, dysentery, diarrhea, jaundice, etc. Pathogens of these diseases are mainly introduced into water bodies through untreated sewage and industrial effluents. Foodborne diseases. Contaminated food also transmits infectious diseases like typhoid, tuberculosis, dysentery, jaundice, and food poisoning.
Now we are going to see about types of disease transmission. It can be direct contact by shaking the hand and sex. It could be transmitted by air such as droplets. It can be transmitted by indirect contact such as an infected person using some such as mobiles or any things which are infected, and the infection is transmitted if a person touches that instrument and touches the hand to the mouth or nose. Or it can be transmitted by food, it can be transmitted by insect or rabid animal. Now we will see about the chain of infection. So the germs which are pathogens. So what are pathogens? It could be bacteria, viruses or parasites. Then these germs, where these germs lives, which is called as reservoir. So these germs lives in people, animals, pets, wild animals, food, soil and water. And how these germs are given out, or they come out by mouth, such as with vomitus. It can be transmitted by cuts or during the changing of diaper or toilet or through stool. Then germs get around, such as contact with hands or toys, or droplets when you speak, sneeze or cough. Then how the germs get in, which is called as portal of entry, again through mouth, cuts in the skin or eyes. And the next sick person, which is what we call it as susceptible host. So who are the susceptible host? Babies, children, elderly people with weakened immune system, unimmunized people or anyone can be infected. Now how to break the chain? The source of infection by the table, the things which are used, are to be cleaned by disinfectant, where we can break the chain. The next thing is that, as we know, these organisms come by coughing or sneezing. So using mask is the way how we break the chain. Then the mode of transmission is by shaking hand. So hand wash is must, by which we can prevent the infection. Then even if we take all these precautions, still it can be transmitted again by taking food. So while taking food, we should have a healthy hygiene practice we should have, so that infection can be controlled. And if person gets some of the symptoms, then early medical help is the key to prevent the disease. And lastly, which is very important, is taking vaccine. So by all these means, we can break the chain. So prevent infectious diseases by all these means. One is wash your hands, obey food safety, practice safe sex, update the vaccines and avoid wild animal bites. Now how to wash your hands? So run your hands under water, lather hands with soap, rub hands together for 20 seconds and rinse hands under again water, dry hands with clean towel. This is the ideal way of hand wash. 20 seconds is very important. Then hand washing habits. When should I wash? After using the bathroom, before eating, after touching a pet or animal, after coughing or sneezing, and after playing outside. Then again I am repeating this because this is very important and easy to follow. When to wash your hands? After playing with pets, after sneezing, coughing and blowing the nose, after playing outside in parks and garden, after using washroom, after and before eating, after touching the wounds, and very important, before cooking also one should have a very thorough wash. Way to control communicable diseases. One is personal hygiene. Hand washing, daily bathing, cutting nails, clean your surroundings, use nets to prevent mosquito, covering the mouth while coughing and sneezing. So these are the very important things one should follow, which is called as personal hygiene. Second is environmental hygiene. Keep your surroundings clean, discard your garbage regularly, use net to protect yourself from mosquito. Third is take vaccination. Follow all childhood immunization schedule. Update your immunization by taking new vaccines according to new diseases, such as we are following our COVID vaccination. Now follow food safety, drink clean water, maintain healthy lifestyle for better immunity by eating balanced diet, doing routine regular physical activity, stress management and have a proper sleep. Now safe sex and control pollution, such as controlling of air, water and soil pollution. These are the ways to control communicable diseases. Now the 5-step MOSI wipeout. Change water in vases and bowls on alternate days. Remove water from flower pot plates on alternate days. Clear blockages such as on roofs or gutters. Then cover bamboo poles holder when not in use and turn over all water storage container, by which we can prevent the dengue and malaria. Then fight with COVID-19. As we all are facing this COVID-19 pandemic, so what are the things to be followed? One is keep a distance of 2 meters or 6 feet. Hand washing again is very important. Use mask properly, which should cover your nose and mouth. Then get vaccinated. If symptom appears, get tested. Maintain healthy lifestyle. So take proper medical help when you need. Then unsafe food affects us all, particularly vulnerable population. As we all know that almost 80% of diseases occurs because of unhealthy food practices which we are doing. So for preventing these, one should have a very clean and clear things, clear ideas in our mind. As we see in COVID, these infections are not because of COVID viruses in as far as food is concerned, but because of our faulty practices, we get infected with the COVID. So keep distance properly, wash your hands properly, always wash the fruits and vegetables properly, by which we can prevent the COVID infection. Because these viruses or these infective materials are on our the things which we are bringing outside. So all these packets should be clean so that these infections we can prevent it. Then prevention of food poisoning. Wash hands and surfaces often. Separately keep raw and finished products. Thoroughly wash fruits and vegetables. Check best before date. And if they are, if you are in doubt, throw these things, do not eat it. Then vaccine is the magic bullet. So we should have a very good vaccination schedule to be followed, and we can prevent many of the diseases by taking vaccines. Then about COVID vaccine, many people have doubts in their mind when and who can take vaccine. So if a person is corona positive, 3 months after recovery, he should take vaccine. If tested positive after first dose of vaccine, second dose after 2 months. Patient who has underwent operation or admitted in ICU, he should take vaccine after 1 to 2 months. Second dose of Covishield to be taken 84 to 122 days after first dose. Lactating mothers can take vaccines. Fever or other minor illnesses 15 days after recovery. Then about blood donation, 15 days after taking vaccine or RT-PCR testing negative. Second dose of Covaxin, 28 to 42 days after the first dose. Then healthy lifestyle, is it matters? Yes, it matters. Healthy lifestyle is very important to improve our immunity, and because of our immunity power, we can prevent many of the diseases. So healthy diet is one of the major factors. Then taking medical help by controlling our comorbidities such as diabetes, blood pressure and obesity, these should be controlled. Third is physical health. By doing regular exercises, we can maintain our physical health. Then taking rest, 8 hours sleep is very important to have a healthy life. Then mental health is also equally important as the physical health. So mental health can be maintained by doing yoga, meditation. So by all these means, we can have our life healthy. Now about healthy diet, eat balanced food, avoid alcohol and smoking, eat one fruit daily, and include protein in our diet. Now, in summary, I can say HEHA. So what is HEHA? H is for hand washing with soap and water for at least 20 seconds. I for immunization. Follow all childhood immunization schedule. Update your immunization by taking new vaccines according to new diseases such as COVID, pneumococcal vaccine and hepatitis B. A for awareness. Aware about given guidelines about specific diseases, for example, using mask for prevention of corona and use nets to prevent yourself from mosquito. So awareness is getting awareness self, and making awareness about the diseases to others will be more important. And H for hygiene, maintain your personal hygiene, keep environmental hygiene and follow food safety. Thank you very much.